Hello, my name's Anthony Hall, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to use the ABF Unwrap to basically UV texture these three small containers that I'm going to use in the previously tutorials I did for the spaceship. So let's start with the first container. So I want to unwrap this container, so let's first go to this view here top and make it UV like so. Okay, just a minute, UV. And then I want to unwrap it. And just hopefully if you follow the other tutorials, what you've got to do is decide how this is going to be unwrapped. So I'm holding shift on my keyboard and I'm selecting, using the edge tool here at the bottom, the seams. Or well, I'm selecting the edges to see how I'm going to unwrap it. So I'm going to unwrap it like this, I think. So here's three seams, and then so it's like a C at the top and a C at the bottom seams, and let's put one here. So let's try that UV ABF wrap, and this is what you get. Look, so you've got the sides going all the way around here, all the way down there, and then you've got the top and the bottom for this one, which is quite nice. So that's all I need. I've already assigned a surface. Let's just rotate, so there you go. So there's the first one ready for to take through. Let's do the next one, exactly the same kind of thing. So I'm going to use the edge and I'm going to select a few edges around the top here. Let's go to select a loop, and let's do the same at the bottom. So I'm saying these want a bit unzipped really, and then let's choose one to separate the sides. Okay, UV ABF unwrap, and then you've got the sides and the two tops, which is quite nice. Let's just rotate this a bit straighter. Have to go in a little bit. And then let's just select these like that. And then, to be honest, these can be all left like the side of each other, really, if you want. I mean, you can move them apart. Oops, just selected all of them. So I'm just right mouse clicking to deselect, so I can just move these. And again, if you want, you can deselect one if you don't want them to be really close to each other, like so. Okay, and then next one is this the flat one. So with this one we'll do let's suppose we could do it the same as the other one, really. So we could say, well, let's say this is your little seam, and then let's do the same at the bottom, and then let's put a joint here. Let's try that. I mean, if it's wrong, we can always try something else. Okay, so this is what it's done. So let's have a look at that. So we've got, there's one top there. And then you've got the sides, yeah, running all the way through the middle, like so. So that's not that bad. I mean, it's not, yeah. So as long as you know they're the sides, that's the top and that's the bottom. I'm going to go with that. It's not exactly what I was expecting, but at the same time, I think it'll work. It'll be all right. So, well, I'll try it anyway, like so. So there we go. There's all our three. And if you bring up your vertex maps and then under textures, there is your ABF unwrap, which the all three are assigned to. So one, you've got one UV name, but they're all assigned to that same UV. You don't need three UVs, you can just assign them to each. They've all got their own texture, so it'll be fine. So I've got one UV And each one of these, when you're on the layer, has them assigned to it. So I'm going to do this with one. What I'll do is I'll just do it with the bowel. I'll just export the bowel to Photoshop and UV texture it and bring it back. And then you, what you have to do is just do the same with the others. So go to the little IO tab. I'm going to export EPS. I don't want the grid. And I just want the UV map itself. I'm going to save it here as container Tony EPS. I'll do. And then press OK. Let's bring up Photoshop. I've collected some images from the internet. So let's open up the new container UV. Leave everything the same. Wait, if you've never brought in EPSs before, just make sure that mode is on RGB. Sometimes come through with CYMK, but change it to RGB. You can leave everything else the same. And there we have it. So now what we've got to do is just populate the inside of this UV. So I've collected a few images. So I'm going to use this one here and use this round bit to make it inside. And I'm going to do it quite quickly and probably quite crudely. So let's just rasterize that and then copy and paste it. And we'll use this for the top and the bottom. So just roughly putting it in there. Still needs to be a bit bigger, I think. I always like to go just a few mil over, maybe a mil, just so it's not going to get any white area. And then I'm copying and pasting this. And if you're wondering how I'm doing it so quickly, I'm just holding Alt and Control on my keyboard. It's like a shortcut to copy and paste. So that'll do for the top. Let's use it to get a side. So I've got another two bit here. Let's just, again, right mouse click rasterize. Just let's use this panel here. Let's say this. So the problem is with this bit is you're going to get this warm bit joined with the warm bit. So you're going to get a line. Maybe I come in to about there because I can, it don't really matter, I can stretch it out. Oh, I could use that bit now. Let's go with this. Let's copy and paste it into a new layer. And then I've just got to fit this into this gap here. Yeah, it's stretching them. Look, but it don't matter. I just want you to see how easy it is. So, yep, I'm happy with that. I'm just going to go File. Save as, save to the computer in the images. Let's call it the same thing, but I'll just call it one. Save it in there, back to modeler, and let's add the texture. So let's double click the barrel. Bring up the node, add node, image node, and then employ color to color, double click it, the node, then where it says image, load the image. So I'm looking for the one I've just done. So into my image folder, oops, choose the actual JPEG. So it's added. Let's go down where it says map, let's make it UV map and wrap. And then it's going to add it to here like so.
Sharp like this.
And at any stage, if you want, you can experiment with these and change it around and so on. So if you wanted to, let's say, so yeah, if you wanted to edit any of this, you could come in. I don't know. Let's just grab. So I'll just play about a minute. So it's lighten that bit around there. Just to show you what I'm on about. So dark and help if I'm on the layer. And again, I'm just come in here, maybe the centre bit here, you really want to be darker than the other bit. Let's turn this right up. So the inside is a lot darker than it was. Just need to keep remembering to switch layers. Okay, that'll do. I'll show that again. File, save as. JPEG. Over the top of the other one, make sure it press replace it, and then it'll update in here. And you can see it get a bit darker, and you can see where I've lightened it there, look, and then darkened it on top. So, yep, hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Look out for my next one.